folks, this is Gabe at Security Baron, and in the world we live in, ghosting is a thing. Some people ghost, some people get ghosted on, but could it be positive in the world of VPNs? Let's check it out today in our review of CyberGhost. All right, in today's review of CyberGhost, we're gonna look at the pros and cons, features, run some speed and leak tests, check out the subscription options, customer support, and finally the mobile application, so you have all the information you need to make the right decision. If you'd like to see a list of our favorite VPNs, Google Security Baron Best VPNs. If you have a question about today's review, leave us a comment and I'll get back to you. Let's look at the pros and cons of CyberGhost VPN, beginning with the pros. Now, they're headquartered in Romania, which is not a part of any international surveillance program, which is great, so you can feel pretty secure with that. And they have some of the best customer support reviews out there. And finally, they have one of the most affordable subscription plans with options as low as $2.75 a month. Now, on the con side, CyberGhost does keep a little bit more of your information than I think is probably necessary, like your IP addresses, which they claim to anonymize. And finally, they do not allow for any split tunneling. So if you want to be on a private network and a public network, you're going to be out of luck. You're going to have to pick one or the other with CyberGhost VPN. Now that we've gone over the pros and cons for CyberGhost VPN, let's check out its feature set, beginning with its data logging policies. Now, most VPNs will keep your name, address, email, username, payment information, but CyberGhost VPN also takes into account how often you use the VPN, what country you're in when you used it, even holds on to your IP address, though it states to anonymize that last bit of information. So for me, that's entirely too much for your VPN company to be holding on to. Now, when it comes to a kill switch feature, they actually do have one, and they engage it in case the VPN goes out. So it's also known as a network lock feature. So if you're browsing the internet, using an app, anything of that nature, it'll automatically stop so that your information isn't exposed to the public network in the case of something happening to your VPN. The next feature we'll look at is split tunneling. Now, split tunneling is something that you'll use to be on a public and private network at the same time, but not something offered by CyberGhost VPN. Now, we like split tunneling because it does allow you to reduce your bandwidth usage, making your internet speed a little bit faster, but unfortunately, CyberGhost does not provide that opportunity. Now, when you're looking at Netflix assets, however, and the constant tug of war between Netflix and VPN companies, CyberGhost is doing pretty well. We were able to use Netflix with CyberGhost. And I will just note that when you're looking at using Netflix UK, you may have to pay more for that IP address. All right, hold on, quick break. CyberGhost VPN is based in Romania, which is outside of the Five Eyes and Nine Eyes and most other international surveillance programs. We're wondering, as a consumer, how important is that to you? We'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments below. All right, let's get back to the video. All right, now that we've gone over the pros and cons and features of CyberGhost VPN, we're gonna put it to the test. And by that, I mean we're gonna give it a speed test, a DNS leak test, and a WebRTC leak test. Just for the sake of transparency, I conducted all of these tests with my control group of a MacBook Air and Asus VivoBook in a Brooklyn apartment on the Optimum network. Let's begin with the speed test, beginning with download speed. Now on my Mac, I only saw a download difference of less than 3% with the VPN as opposed to without it. But my VivoBook didn't fare as well with a 20% decrease in download speed. And honestly, upload speed followed the same trend with a difference of only 7% on my Mac and 47% on my Windows computer. Now, the final thing that I went over was latency, or, you know, ping. And if you're a gamer, you want to keep that latency to a minimum. So again, there was an increase of 14% on the Mac, but 77% on the VivoBook. So it appears from my experience that CyberGhost does better with Mac users in terms of speed over PC users. All right, so let's conduct a DNS leak test. Now, DNS stands for Domain Name Server, and it's essentially when you type in google.com, but there's actually a longer IP address underneath that you don't want to be divulged to everyone out there. Now, with CyberGhost VPN, it passed that leak test with flying colors. So let's move on to the next one, which is the WebRTC leak test. Now, WebRTC stands for Web Real-Time Communication, and it's essentially what is used whenever you connect two computers directly together without going through an intermediate server. So that's something that happens on Chrome and Firefox when you're transferring large files, doing a video chat, or live streaming. So you don't want that private IP address to go to the other party. But fortunately for us, CyberGhost VPN did not allow that information to leak out. And once again, it passed the WebRTC leak test with flying colors. All right, let's check out the subscription options for CyberGhost VPN. If you sign up for 3 years, it's gonna be $275 a month. If you sign up for 2 years, it's gonna be $369 a month. If you sign up for a year, it's gonna be $599 a month or $1,299 monthly. Now, the great thing with CyberGhost VPN is you're gonna get access to over 3,700 servers in numerous countries, and you can connect up to 7 devices simultaneously. Now, if you want a dedicated IP address, that'll just cost you an extra $5 a month. Now, in terms of offerings, that's pretty impressive from CyberGhost VPN. All right, so let's check out customer support for CyberGhost VPN. Now, CyberGhost VPN has a few ways for you to get in touch with them. You can go to their online help center, of course, and see if you can figure out the problem yourself using the FAQs. You can even create a ticket so they can answer your question over time. But what we like the most, and it probably gets you what you need most immediately, it's going to be their live chat feature. Now, live chat, you can go in, ask someone a question, and they'll get right back to you. Now, when it comes to what people are saying about CyberGhost, it's pretty positive. It has a 3.6 out of 5-star rating on Amazon and a full 5-star rating on Trustpilot. And most of the reviews that specifically mention customer support are very positive. And what we like the most and we thought was representative of what CyberGhost is doing in the customer support arena is that they responded to every single person. So if you had a question, you had an issue, and it was in your review, CyberGhost actually responded to you, which is top-notch support. So CyberGhost is really going above and beyond when it comes to customer support. The last thing we want to address today is this CyberGhost application available on Windows, Mac, Android, iOS, Linux, but we want to focus specifically on the mobile applications. Now, with Android, it gets a 4.3 out of 5-star rating in the Google Play Store. Whereas with Apple App Store, it does do as well, but it's not bad with a 3.4 out of 5-star rating. So let's just go ahead and check it out on my iPhone 10. All right, here we are checking out the CyberGhost VPN on my iPhone 10. Now, if I click right there in the middle, it'll give me a New York VPN. You see that big old button right there with the power on and off button, but let's check out best location. So here you have a lot of servers available. And it's interesting to have these different servers from all these different countries. If you click in the middle where it says streaming, you can actually look at the United States, optimized for Netflix, optimized for Hulu, optimized for Crunchyroll, optimized for YouTube in Germany, which is pretty cool. You have a ton of different options, optimized for HBO Go Romania. And you know, for someone like me who actually used to watch a lot of Globo, you got optimized for Globo Brazil. So, let's go back, or actually let's just pick one of these. Let's go to optimize for Hulu United States. Click on that button in the middle, connecting, and boom, here I am, based in Dallas. So it's pretty straightforward. If I click this, I can disconnect. If I wanna go to another location, go to Costa Rica, boom, now I'm connected to Costa Rica. San Jose, very straightforward. So basically that's all there is to the CyberGhost app. You can reset to best location here at the bottom, which will get you to the fastest server based on your location. You got that big button in the middle that you can tap with on your iPhone or your Android. You can look at the various servers. I love being in different countries at different times. If you wanna be in Japan, if you wanna be in Iceland, if you wanna be in Denmark or Chile, it's just a straightforward, intuitive app. Connects almost instantly, and it's pretty simple to use. So that's our look at the CyberGhost VPN app. All right, we've come a long way with the CyberGhost VPN, and I've yet to ghost on you. But you wanted to know, hey, is this the right VPN for me? And well, if you're someone who really wants to use Netflix, have an affordable option for a VPN, and have excellent customer support, then you might want to look at CyberGhost, especially if you're a Mac user. And I say that because some of the cons are that it isn't the fastest, or at least it wasn't the fastest for me on my Windows computer. Additionally, I do think they keep a little bit more information on you than necessary. Of course, that might be mitigated to some extent by the fact that they're outside of all international surveillance programs, but just something to keep in mind. And finally, it definitely doesn't allow for you to do any split tunneling. So that can also be a concern for those of you who want to be on the public and private network at the same time. But overall, yes, I'm happy with CyberGhost. I think they provide a lot of functionality and flexibility in the VPN marketplace. So that concludes our review of CyberGhost VPN. If you appreciate today's video, give us a like and hit that subscribe button. As always, this is Gabe, Security Baron. Be secure.